I'm excited to be before you guys today. It's been a while. I miss you guys. Matter of fact, my pockets miss you guys. Wow, wow, wow. It's good to see so many black people in the house tonight. Come on, black people, make some noise. All two of y'all. Okay, okay. That's good. Come on, I ain't gonna leave white people out. White people, make some noise. That's because the black people outnumber the white people. Wow, wow. You do know you're sitting in the front tonight, right? This is wonderful. Will y'all give this up? Listen, will y'all give yourself a round of applause for this lady right here? Come on, let's say this again. Come on. I took one look at her and I said, wait a minute, is that Katy Perry? Really? That's celebrities in the house? No, actually, I was going to be Treasure Troll, actually. I'll be honest. So I'm the Treasure Troll, so it's that night for some people. Anybody dating tonight? Oh, y'all all single. Wow, I'm single too. Don't write my name down on the ballot, just write your number. So I just told you, I'm single, I'm newly single. Okay, don't write about that either. Okay, it's okay. Well, you know, I'm meeting interesting women and I thought I met the one until she got comfortable. And she said, baby, you know I love hard. If you ever leave me, I'll quit my job. I said, boy, I love hard too. If you ever leave me, I'll get one. So, you know, I like to get romantic, and you know, I get out on a little road trip, and I say, I'm going to take on a road trip. We're going to drive down to Charleston, South Carolina. And you know, it's one thing I love about women. I love women, but y'all sneaky and y'all nasty, too. Let's just be real. So we ride in the car. It's hot outside. Windows up. AC's on. And I noticed she's looking out the window. And I said, okay, well, she admired the scenery, you know. And then all of a sudden, I noticed she started cocking her leg up towards me. And I was like, really? Really, you gonna do that? She said, what? I said, you just gonna fart in the car? She said, no, that wasn't me, that was the baby. I said, we don't have kids. I was just sneaky, just nasty. Man. And what's up with the kids, man? I don't know, we got some bad. My kid is so bad, I take them to the park just to get abducted. Shoot the littles when I put a little note on them and say, you found, keep them. You know, we're in the Bible Belt. Y'all know what that means. That means church folk. Y'all know we got some church folk in the house. Any church folk in the house, say amen. And I think non-denomination churches. You know, I grew up Baptist. And the problem with a Baptist church, we stay in church way too long. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Yes. Can I get amen? Amen. All right. So we're in church, and I remember, listen to this. I remember when I was 4 years old going to church one Sunday. And we were in church so long, I literally aged in the church. By the time we got out of the church, I was six. And with a beard. Just graduated high school. You know, my mom tells me, she said, boy, you're disrespectful. You should pray more. So I said, okay, I'm going to try this prayer thing. And here's one thing I like about prayer. Prayer is the perfect language to God, to whereas you know you messed up, but you got an excuse to say whatever it is you want. So I had a prayer, and I prayed for my son the other day. And I said, Lord God, just... I thank you for being all wise and holy, and thank you for your protection, God, and thank you, Lord, for having your angels protect my hands from strangling this child. Lord, I just thank you for protecting me from throwing him across the room, God, and came in his chest in Jesus' name. Amen. And I woke up, I opened my eyes up, and Child Protective Services was there. Thank you, guys. My time is up.